Today one of my students asked me a few questions of chapter exponent and power through WhatsApp, and I think this question is of standard 8. So now I'm going to solve it, and I'm solving this sum. I'm putting on YouTube also so that other students also get the benefit. The first question is minus 2 to the power 5 into 3 to the power 5 whole square divided by 12 into 3 to the power 7. We are going to solve first of all this one. And today I have decided to solve the sum in two different methods. First, by using the rules of exponent and power, and the second method without using any rules and regulation. So let's see how we'll solve the sum. First method. By using rules of powers and exponent. Actually, we need to solve the sum by this method only. But for those students who don't know, who are below standard 8, they don't know the rules of the power and exponent. That's why I've decided without using any formula also I will solve the sum so that the concept will be clear. So the question was minus 2 to the power 5 into 3 to the power 5 whole square divided by 12 into 3 to the power 7. First of all, what we will do, this base number must be prime number. What we have seen, the first number is 2, that is prime number. 3 is also prime number. 12 is composite number, so we will break 12 into prime numbers, multiples of prime number. 3 is already in prime numbers. So what I am going to do, let's see. Minus 2 to the power 5 into 3 to the power 5 whole square divided by, instead of writing 12, we can write 2 into 2 into 4. See, because 12 is equals to 2 into 2 into 3. Why I have written 2 into 2 into 3? Because these all are the prime numbers and this was composite number. So, and the last number was 3 to the power 7. Now, what I am going to do, here is minus 2 to the power 5. So what I will do, minus 2 to the power 5, here power to the power. We have learned a rule that p to the power m to the power n, it means p to the power m into n. First rule, power of any number and another power, both the powers will be multiplied. So what I will write here is 3 to the power 5 to the power 2. So we will write 5 into 2 by using this formula, this rule. Power to the power will be multiplied. Base will be as it is, but the powers will be multiplied. And now, what I will do here, sorry, this was 3, not 4. So, 2 square, instead of writing 2 into 2, we can write 2 square into 3, into 3 to the power 7. So, overall, one more thing we can do here, that minus 2 means what? Minus 2 can be written as minus 1 into 2, is it or not? Minus 1 into 2 is minus 2. So, what I have done, I have written like this, minus 1 into 2. And here, 2 square into 3 to the power nothing means 3 one time. And here is also 3 to the power 7. And we learned another rule that if same ways are there, but then powers are different, we can write this number as p to the power m plus n. If two numbers are multiplied with same or different powers, if the bases are same, we can combine it. We will write once the base and the powers will be added. So same thing we will use here, that is 3 to the power 1 into 3 to the power 7 means what? 3 to the power 1 plus 7, is it? Now, I can do one thing, that's minus 1 to the power 5 will be separated from the bracket, and here 2 to the power 5, here 3 to the power 10, 5 to the 10 divided by 2 square into 3 to the power 8. Why I did all these things? Why? because I'm trying to do one thing, I'm selecting the different same type of bases. See, now we are having 2 as base in numerator, 2 as base in denominator. Similarly here, 3 as base in numerator, 3 as base in denominator. So we can solve it together. I will show you how it is possible, and similarly here also. Now we will think, minus 1, we will multiply 5 times means what? What will the answer? It is minus 1. Because minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5. So 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 means 1. Minus, minus, plus. Minus, minus, plus. Both plus, plus is plus. And 1 minus is minus. So answer will be minus. So for this value, it is overall minus 1. Now we are having 2 to the power 5 and 2 square. We can write it like 2 to the power 5 minus 2. And for this one, for these two number, we can write 3 to the power 10 minus 8. Which rule we have used here, you just see here. Exponent and power rule says that if the numbers are in this way, the bases are same, only the powers are same or different, what we can do, we can combine both the numbers. We'll write the single time base and both the numbers will be subtracted, powers will be subtracted, and we have to write this single time that base. Same thing I did it here. You can see 3 to the power 10, 3 to the, both the numbers are divided. Okay, this was the numerator, this is denominator. So what I did, subtracted the number 10 minus 8. And here 2 to the power 5 and 2 square means both the numbers are in division condition. So what will do? I did it. Now, minus 1, 2 to the power into 2 to the power 3. 5 minus 2 is 3. And 3 to the power 2. So here, minus 1 will carry on with it. Okay. So now, what will do? Open it. 2, 3 times means what? Directly we can do it, but maybe the junior students will see the video. That's why I'm doing all the steps thoroughly. And here is 3 into 3. Now we will multiply. 3 3s are 9. 9 2s are 18. 18 2s are 36. And 36 2s are 72. 72 into minus 1 is minus 72. This is our answer. Now I will solve this sum without using any formula. And let's see. The answer will be the same or not.